インタビュー始めたいと思います。お願いします。
お願いします。
Welcome to Japan. It's very nice to have you here again.
Thank you. Thank you.
How do you feel to fight in Japan again?
I feel good. I feel good.
日本でもう一度戦えるってことでどうですかって言ったら、とても嬉しい。
And talk a little bit about that. If you think about this returning to Japan, do you come back to old bright days and remember all history you make here in Japan, especially in K1 and after that in Pride?
Of course, I remember Pride days, especially because of Saitama Super Arena. And, I had 20 fights in Saitama. This will be 21st fight.I have beautiful memories from Saitama, and the same people are doing the are running the Rising now as they did with Pride, and I feel good.
あのプライドそれから K1 の時代っていうのを思い出しながら今回また日本で戦われるんでしょうかっていう質問なんですけれども、この埼玉で戦うの今回31回目ということで、もちろんあの頃の記憶っていうのはしっかりと残ってるし、でライジンもあの頃の方たちが運営されているということで、その記憶はとてもあります。
We see a lot of videos about your campTo Rising, you do a lot of stuff with your coaches. How is your preparation for that fight? And I think you say in the last press conference you coming to be a champion. Now it's not to do an only fight in there. And how is your preparation, especially for this fight, and think about in the next two fights in December?
My shape is very good now for this fight. The whole preparation went without any problem, trouble. We had a hard camp, a lot of sparring, lot of everything, you know, and my condition is really good.
今回いろいろなコンディショニングというか、練習をしているところの様子、まあ、キャンプの様子がですね、ビデオ動画でも上がっているんですけれども、かなり準備をされているようですが、いかがでしょうかということで、まあ、おっしゃる通りですね、かなり今回の試合に向けて、その調整もかけてきています。スパーリングですとかハードキャンプを行いました。で、12月に向けてもうどうでしょうかというご質問だったんですけれども、まあ、今回の試合に向けて、かなり準備をしていますと。
The people still got have a lot of surprise when Rising announced your opponent. Do you think the fans can be not do much respect about your opponent, because you have a fight, you have a face a Road FC guy, and he have some skills to compete against you?
I don't understand what you wanted to ask.
I expect because the fans not respect about your opponent.
Who has no respect?
The fan, the media and the MMA fans.
Well, nobody
because
should
not have.
Nobody should underestimate anyone. It's very nice that they consider me as a big favorite in this fight, but he's 12 years younger and heavier and taller. But of course, it means nothing because I'm. My body is in really good shape now, and I had a great camp, and my stamina is excellent, and of course I have a much lot of more experience than he has, and nobody shouldn't be underestimated in especially in MMA, especially in heavyweight division. Small gloves, almost bare hands, and anybody can punch. He will be definitely motivated, hungry to beat me, to make his name much bigger than he is now, but I will do my best not to let him to do that.
まあ、相手敵ですね、ヒョンマン選手なんですけれども、決して彼の力を、見下してはいけないと思うんですね。確かにその日本における注目度が低いんじゃないかという質問をいただきましたけれども、彼は私よりも12歳年下で、背も高い、そして体重もある、で、まあ、今回来ていらっしゃる選手の皆さんって、一生懸命今回勝つためにトレーニングを積んでいらっしゃる方々ですから、その実力っていうものを決して見下してはいけないと思います。ただそういうものも私も今回キャンプを非常に厳しいものを遂げてきて、スタミナもあります、力もついている、そして何より私には経験値というものがあるので、まあ、戦う相手としては不足はないと思います。
10年前に2006年 の, あの プライドの無差別級グランプリを優勝されてると思うんですけど、無差別級グランプリに、特別な思いがありますか、今回出る。
So 10 years ago, back in 2006, you won the Openweight Grand Prix. So do you have any strong attachment or special attachment to this Openweight?
No. This is fights just like any other tournament. I like tournament system.
Mm-hmm.
I like tournament system. Mm-hmm. Two fights in one night, and mm-hmm. if everything goes well, mm-hmm. On Sunday, I might have, if I want to win the tournament, I might have three fights in practically 2 days. Mm-hmm. 29, this is quarterfinal and then semifinal and final, mm-hmm. which is very hard, mm-hmm. you know, and it needs a lot of strength, mm-hmm. stamina, mm-hmm. strategy to stay out of injury. Mm-hmm. And but I like it. Mm-hmm. It is a big challenge for everybody, not just for me.
Mm-hmm. 特にその無差別級だからっていう気持ちはないんですけれども、そのトーナメント戦って好きなんですね。っていうのは1日で複数戦うっていうこともあり、2日間で勝ち残ればですね、3回の試合がある。でかなりこれってストレスもたまるし、スタミナが必要で、戦略も必要です。だからこういうトーナメント戦で戦えるっていうのは私はとても好きなんです。
So, do you have a strategy at this time?
Strategy. My strategy was always to be covered in every segment of the fight. Mm-hmm. I mean, first of all, the most important thing is stamina and condition.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of experience. I know how to kick. I know how to punch. But always it is always about the stamina. You know? Mm-hmm. So many people are good fighters, but they run out of stamina after a few minutes, or if they enter the second round, they are not even half of their performance in the first round. So stamina is most important.
Mm-hmm.
I think when I'm talking about myself and people who compete on my level,
mm-hmm.
I know everything about fighting. I'm very skilled, and it's about stamina.
Mm-hmm.
It's about conditioning.
Mm-hmm.戦略っていうものももちろんいろいろと持つんですけれども、何より大切なのはスタミナだと思うんですね。それからコンディショニングっていうのも、いくら技があってもスタミナがないと、最後まで戦い切る力っていうものが、自分の実力っていうのを発揮できなくなってしまいますから、やっぱりその技っていうだけではなくって、スタミナ、そしてコンディショニングというところがとても重要だと思ってます。
I'm pretty sure that you have confidence to win your fight. And how
would
you celebrate
your
victory?
How do you celebrate?
Yes.
I don't celebrate too much. Just go to hotel and I will go sleep, and next morning I will go home. That's it.
勝ったらどうやって祝うんですかという質問ないですけれども、特に祝いませんと。試合が終わったらホテルに帰って寝て、次の朝飛んで帰ります。
バンダレ・シウバ選手と2006年の時も戦って勝たれていると思うんですけども、今回バンダレ選手は12月にから出場ということで、バンダレ選手はミルコス選手とまた戦いたいって言ってたんですけども、それをちょっと。
So back in 2006, you fought against Silva, Vanderlei, and Silva had mentioned that he is looking forward to fighting against with you again in December. Mm-hmm. What do you think about his statement?
It will be a nice matchup. It will be very nice to kick his ass again.
またケツを蹴ってやれるのが楽しみだと。
Complementing his question, do you have preference in to face in the final just Vanderlei, or we have a lot of new fighters coming, we have a lot of talents too, we don't know what's
going to happen. Well, I came here to win the tournament. I don't know if I will be able to do it, you know, the competition will be hard, much younger fighters are coming, but I will do my best, of course. I will do my best. I came here completely relaxed, you know, and that's my advantage.
Mm.
I don't have to build any career, you know. I just came here because I like it. It's my passion, and because I feel good. And I will do my best. And I enjoy the training like I never did before. And they should take care, you know. They should be very careful. Whoever enters the ring with me, I don't know who is going to be your first fight. Possibly Vanderlei. I have nothing against it. I respect him a lot. He's a great fighter, one of the true legends of MMA. But I will do my best to finish the fight like I did in 2006.
あの今回あのシルバー次回ですねシルバー選手に関わらず、まあ、いろんないい才能を持った若い選手たちもいるので、まあ、そういった選手とも戦える機会のも楽しみではないでしょうかというような質問だったんですけれどもあのそうですねいろんな選手と戦えるというのもとてもあの楽しみだとも思いますし何よりやっぱりそこで試合があるから戦うんだという気持ちになっているのでどんな選手であれ戦う場所にいれば戦うということですね、私が持っている強みというのはこの経験に基づいたリラックスができるっていうところだと思いますなのでそれが我々私の強みなので、日本にいてとてもあの大好きな国でありそして、心地よく過ごせる環境というものもあるし今まで以上にトレーニングというのも楽しみながらやってますから反対にあの他の選手たちは私にちゃんと気をつけた方がいいと思います
My last question is what do you expect about future? Because you fought this year in Rising andYou announced before you a retirement and now you come back.
I don't know.
Do you want to spend more years competing?
I don't expect too much for the future. I turned 42 a few days ago, and but I feel good. I feel good, and it still makes me happy, and I still enjoy my trainings. And at the end of the day, that's my life. That's my job. That's my passion.But unfortunately, the human body has its limits, you know, and I don't feel them yet, but I don't know how I'm going to feel next year or in 2 years. So far, I made a deal with Rising to do this, only this tournament,